NBC takes pride in offering another concert in miniature encores, bringing you the fresh creative efforts of Stan Kenton and a select group of musicians that present their conception of modern idiom of American jazz. This program is coming to you tonight direct from the world-famous Hollywood Palladium. And now, here is your conductor, modern America's man of music, Stan Kenton.
Thank you very much, Warren. Ladies and gentlemen, it's early evening here in California at the Palladium, and we're presenting this broadcast. It's quite a bit later, of course, in the East. The thing this evening will sound rather formal because we are not having the audience participate with the broadcast this evening. So in order to get things off to a formal beginning, a jazz show formally should have something we'll say that's rhythmic in content in order to give you the overall effect. Here's a light, simple thing, one of the Mulligan's things. We want to play this thing, gentlemen. It's called Swing House. The beat, give you five beats. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Called Swing House and a few soloists. They're called Frankie Rosolino. He plays trombone. There's Lee Konitz with an alto saxophone, Richie Kamuca for a short portion, and he divided up with Conte Candoli. You know, some melodies that are created are things that are pretty much what we call pretty and sweet in content, and then there are others that are pretty and sweet in content and also lend themselves well toward the jazz treatment. Of course, those are generally numbers that enjoy a great popularity, such as this next number. It pretty much can be played with a string section in a lovely manner. You can stomp this one out with a lot of rhythm, or you can create a mood such as shall be created at the moment by Bob Burgess here in the orchestra. Here is Over the Rainbow.
Ha 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 ha.
Ladies and gentlemen, I speak so much here on the concert miniature encores as well as the concert miniature programs that I thought for a moment that I would try something rather unique. Because I have to be with the rhythm section at the beginning of this, I think that I'd like to have one of the stars in the trumpet section introduce another star. It'd be interesting to see what he says. So, Maynard Ferguson, would you be kind enough to introduce this cohort of yours or your sidekick? Say the things that you think should be said about the guy and a little bit about the way he plays and so forth, and then get him to start blowing.
Well, I'm afraid if I said everything that I'd like to say about the Count, I'd be out here for the rest of the show, and Count wouldn't even get to blow. So we'll simply say that the wonderful Count, playing his wonderful jazz, playing... What are you going to play?
Round Robin.
County Candoli playing Round Robin. We'll be right back.
heard one trumpet player, Maynard Ferguson, introduce another trumpet player, Conte Candoli, and what he didn't say is it was written by another trumpet player, Shorty Rogers. And speaking of introducing other people, I wish I had him here to introduce, but I don't have him, but I'll have to, at the moment, get along without him as best I can and introduce a composition of his. But if I were Duke Ellington, going to introduce this special thing of his that has been so closely identified with him for so many years, I probably would sound like this. How do you do? Love you madly, he'd say that, of course. Then he'd continue on, he'd say something about the delightful crowd he's presenting the music for, and one of the romantic compositions out of his library, he'd possibly say, "It's our pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, sophisticated lady." You know, it's an amazing thing, the scope of music and all of the different emotions that it can project, all the different feelings and so forth. There are people that only prefer a romantic music. Everything else seems to bore them or bother them. There are people that seem to want a music that's more pointed and direct. They can become pretty much lackadaisical, I should say, an attitude with romantic things. So is it true with those of us in music. Sometimes you hear a beautiful string section and you'll say, how could anything surpass that in character and feeling? Until once you hear a powerful brass section with a throb that can be created with rhythms, then you begin to balance the two. You say, are the violins so, or can it be brass? At the moment, this thing has been designed to pretty much support the brass section. A few short solos, but it's something Cuban in content. Here's the arrangement that's been done so much that it deserves to be called an encore. That fella's taboo. Here's an interesting thing. This is supposed to be a concert miniature encore program. That is music that is a part of the regular concert and miniature program that appears each Saturday night on NBC. And here we are with a number for the first time on the air, either concert and miniature or encore, and it's appearing on the wrong program. This is an encore, but it's for the first time we're playing on the... What am I saying? For the first time on the air, we'll say we've got to jump on the concert miniature program this time when we present Sal Salvador's the guitar, all mixed in with these sounds that go to make up the standard tune called Gone with the Wind. Thank you. Sal, you know, there was about three beats there in which I was waiting for you and you were waiting for me. Should you always wait for me or shall I wait for you? How should it be done? Okay, you've given me the look. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to step out of the road for the moment and ask Warren Miles to explain this next number because, as usual, there is some sort of a complication because I don't have the piano right here in front of me. I'd like to make it over there. Mr. Miles, would you show us the courtesy of explaining?
Well, it would certainly be a pleasure, Stan. Now, as Stan goes to the 88, we're getting ready for a little jump, jive session here, and it's called Jump for Joe.
Just a moment. You know, there have been a few expressions here in through improvisations and so forth. I wonder if you'd like to take a chorus.
I would like to say, Stan, that for the past 30 minutes, you have been entertained by Stan Kenton and his orchestra as they brought up their concert and miniature encores, fresh interpretations of modern America's jazz. This concert, of course, has come to you direct from the world-famous Hollywood Palladium through the facilities of the National Broadcasting Company. This is Warren Miles bidding you one and all good night for Stan Kenton and all the boys in the band.
This is NBC, the National Broadcast.